In this video, we'll be discussing the basics of PI System Explorer, or PSE as it is frequently referred to for short. PI System Explorer is the main tool for configuring and managing PI System Asset Framework, PI Notifications, and PI Event Frames. We'll start by opening PI System Explorer by going to All Programs, PI System Folder, and I'm looking for an icon with a yellow background and a magnifying glass. Now, as PSE starts up, you'll notice that the screen is divided into several different sections. So we'll go over each of these, starting in the bottom left. We have what is known as the Navigator pane. Here you'll see that there are several different objects that you may want to work on within PI System Explorer. In this course, our primary focus will be on elements and library options. In the elements section, which is where your hierarchy resides, this can be either a physical or logical representation of your process. The library is a collection of objects that you can use throughout your AF hierarchy. This includes templates, enumeration sets, tables, etc. Although not modified in this course, but it should be acknowledged due to its importance, is the unit of measure. This database provides automatic handling of simple conversions between unit of measures for attributes of the same unit of measure class. A unit of measure class is defined by the fundamental dimension of its measurement. Some examples of unit of measure classes are mass, temperature, volume, and density. You may have noticed, as we selected different sections in the Navigator pane, available options were changing above it. This section is known as the Browser. With elements selected, your hierarchy is visible. If the library is selected, options to work on building templates, tables, enumeration sets are brought into view. To the right of the browser, we have the Viewer, which is your primary work area. From this pane, we can build templates, add attributes, configure tables, etc. The final section we can display is called the Palette. By default, the pane is hidden to optimize screen visibility and workspace. To make the palette visible, go to View Menu, Select Palette, and Show Palette. From the palette area, we have several options available. For now, we will mention the tag search. We can perform a tag search, allowing us to quickly drag and drop already defined data into the attribute area to make new attributes on the template. Another option to increase viewing space is to minimize the configuration window. If we explore the menu options, we can see one item labeled Go. This menu option gives keyboard shortcuts to traverse the Navigator pane. The last thing to mention is the status bar. It is at the base of PI System Explorer window. This will tell you the status of a selected element. For example, from the library, I have selected the press template. You can identify that it was last modified and by whom from the status bar. To review, we went over the major components of PI System Explorer. The components being the status bar, menu bar, the navigator panel for selecting groups of objects to work on, the browser for selecting individual objects, the viewer for configuring objects, and finally, the palette, where we have quick access to templates and tags for dragging and drop editing.